College. Our college is Alpha College of Engineering that is situated near Poonamalli. So this is about myself. So I am Dr. B. Soumya, Principal Alpha College of Engineering. So I have nearly 25 years of experience both in the academic and research field. So this is our college. This is actually very much nearer to Chennai, situated at Tirumalai near Poonamalli. The college was established in the year 2006 with an area of 65 acres and the built-up area is 12 acres. Our college is approved by ACT and it is affiliated to Anna University. Moreover, this is an ISO 9001:2015 certified institution. The certification has been given by ISO for its standard. The courses offered are UG programs and PG programs, both we offer. UG program in Bachelor of Engineering stream as well as Bachelor of Technology stream. Then we have got a PG program, that is Master of Business Administration. In engineering stream, we offer four programs, that is Biomedical Engineering, Computer Science and Engineering, Electronics and Communication Engineering, and Mechanical Engineering. Under BTech stream, that is under technology program, what we offer is Information Technology. So our main aim to help the student be the best in their chosen field. That is what we want our students to be. We want them to be the best when they go out of the college. For that, we have got student assisting units. One is Career Development Cell, another one is Entrepreneurship Development Cell. Then we have got Big Training Cell, SISMEM Training, as well as PALS. So our Career Development Cell, what we do is we train them on aptitude, that is their logical reasoning, analytical reasoning, all those reasoning skills that has to improve. So for that, we give them aptitude training. Then for them to be a part of a team and act, be participant in any team activity, we develop their interpersonal skills with the interpersonal skills training. Then for them to communicate better, we offer them soft skills training. So overall, these aptitude training, interpersonal skills training, as well as soft skills training, help them develop their overall personality so that when they do move out of the college, they would be very much eagerly taken by the industry because their overall personality is such that they would be attracting industries to choose them. Then we got the Entrepreneurship Development Cell. So as we feel that our students should not necessarily be a job seeker and we want them to be a job provided, we have got the CDC Cell. So what it actually does is we do a tie-up with very prestigious institutions like NSIC, MSME, NEON, Enactus, everything. So what these institutions are doing is they give us that they actually gauge our projects. The students' projects are gauged by these industries and they do help them start up their own venture. So for the they would become their own owner of the industry. Then we have got the Business English certification that is offered by the Cambridge University. This is an internationally acclaimed certification course. As you know, whatever knowledge you possess, unless you communicate, it cannot be known to others. So for that, we have to be sure of our language skills. So for that, what are the four skills of any language for that matter is listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So all these four skills we train our students on so that their employability and communication skills would improve. Then we've got the Center of Excellence. First one is Cisco Laboratory, that is CCNA certification is offered by this. This Cisco Laboratory, that is a networking laboratory, and they offer networking certification. So usually it is meant for electronics and communication engineers and computer science engineers. So other engineers who wants to be well-versed in networking also can learn, because networking is part of any engineer, because what you are doing is now also we are communicating through networks. So that is happening. Then we have got the Autodesk Implementer certification that is offered by the Autodesk. That is mainly meant for mechanical engineers. With that, they do their CAD project and they do develop projects automatically for their industries. Then we have got Oracle Java Programming and R Programming certification that is offered by the Oracle Academy of a College. Then we have got Big Data Analytic Design that is offered by the Delhi EMC. So all these certification programs, if you do see, these certification programs would cost you when you do it outside, and they will be charging you much. Even Cisco level, if you can see that there are five levels, even a single level would cost you 20,000 to 25,000. So instead of that, all these programs we offer free of cost. The student can choose any program they want, and they can get themselves well versed, and the certification will be provided by the respective industry. Then anybody's dream for that, an engineer, what he wants to be, where he wants to study. If you ask a student in their HSC exam, passed out student, if you ask them, so what they usually say is they want to do it in IIT. So, but the cracking JEE mains itself is difficult, and advanced is so difficult. So getting into IIT is very difficult, and the numbers of seats are also limited. So if a student's dream is to be in IIT and they do not get that, then we want our student who have a dream to be an IITian. So for them, we tied up with PALS, that is Pan IIT Leadership Series. So this is run by the alumni of IIT, and this usually is tied up with IIT Chennai. And this IIT series, what it does is they bring professionals from IIT and give seminars, professors from IIT and give seminars. Then they do offer residential workshops at IIT itself. Our students go and stay in IIT for 5 days and do their projects there at IIT. So they get the gist of what is happening at IIT with this collaboration with PALSA. Then they do arrange industrial visits, and they offer Innovo competitions also. That is an innovative idea competition. So that is offered to all these students. The students participate in Innovo competition, and they do showcase their projects there. There are two leading industries, the leading countries. One is SwissMEMS, Switzerland, and other one is Germany. So these industries, if you do consider, what they do is precision engineering. So the micro precision, because now we have gone from micro level to nano level, so that precision is being offered by these two countries. They are the pioneers in engineering field, that is Switzerland and Germany. So to get the best engineering certification, we have tied up with Switzerland, that is SwissMEMS, that is a leading technical association for engineering industries in Switzerland. They do offer these training programs. One is machine learning and mechatronics. This machine learning and mechatronics, if you do consider at this pandemic time, this is very much essential, because we need an automation of anything, because we don't want any contact between human beings. That being the case, mechatronics and machine learning comes into a important role. So if you consider mechatronics will be a part of mechanical and electronic engineers. Any robot is built with mechanical parts. As you know, it has arms, it has to move. So all these things, electrical and mechanical, are part of it. So you have to make the gears, you have to make the robo move. So that is only the mechanical part. Where electronics comes into picture is, we do not want that to be happen with very big motors and all. So what we want to do is, we want to give those commands with small chips, where the chip is embedded into the mechanical part. So that embedded system makes the robot to move. Then if you want the robot to learn, that is act on its own if you want it to, then what you will be doing, you would be providing it with intelligence. So machine learning is part of that artificial intelligence, which we do offer the machines. So if you consider that robot is a machine, and we give knowledge to that, so that from that knowledge, it learns things on. For example, a humanoid robot meant for nursing patient, if you consider, then what it actually does is, it would be automatically taking the temperature. If the temperature is high, it would automatically feeding them what is the medicine required, which has been fed by the doctor. So this machine learning and mechatronics is part of all engineers. So that's why we have chosen this course, because it takes up the computer science for programming part, electronics for doing the embedded system, and mechanical for doing building the machine, and built together in machine learning and mechatronics part. That's why we have chosen this course, and this course we are offering a student free of cost. Then we have tied up with SkillRack, and we offer our students online courses. So one is Python, C. All these online courses are being offered through SkillRack. This is for improving their programming skills as well as for that, we keep on giving this online. if you do consider, our college stood at 48th rank in the top 100 engineering colleges in India. And this is one of her student, Malavika Nair, receiving the gold medal. That is, she stood as first in Anna University university examinations. She is a 2018 positive student. Then we got the teaching from Education Matters. Then other achievements, to list a few, we have got this, that is consistent ranks and gold medals we have been producing. Then our students and staff, they do get funded projects from government agencies like Tamil Nadu State Council of Science and Technology, AACT, ISRO, etc. Then we offer our students industrial training and internship in leading industries, not only in India and abroad as well. Our students have consistently given us 100%, we have given our students 100% placement. Then our students' projects also have been acclaimed by awards. Then we have got this higher studies in India and abroad our students are doing. So mainly in European countries, Canada, USA, our students are pursuing their higher studies. And our college has got excellent sports facilities with spacious grounds, both for football and cricket. And our students have won gold medals both in zonal and state levels. And we offer scholarship to our students, that is SCST student, 100% tuition fee waiver is there. And for first graduate, we do offer 25,000 fee concession. And we offer merit scholarship for students whose MPC marks are above 90 as well as above 75. The slab would be different for 75 range and 90 range. And our learning environment is friendly. This is an amicable learning environment. We have got a dedicated faculty who would be teaching these students, seeing their levels and whatever knowledge they want to take from our staff, they are welcome to do so. And they will. And we have got polite non-teaching staff members who are well behaved. Overall, the environment, what you find in Alpha, is very amicable. And this is actually a home away from home. The student and staff are, their rapport is such that you will feel as if you are at home. So this is a home away from home. So I welcome you all to Alpha College of Engineering to be part of Alpha team. So you stay at home, stay informed and stay safe during this pandemic time. We want your safety. So with more and more programs like this, we would be reaching you. Thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Principal Ma'am.
Over to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Principal Ma'am. Now I would like to invite Tamilselvi Ma'am, Professor in HOD of Mathematics Department, to handle the workshop session today. Ma'am, over to you, ma'am.
Okay. I'm sorry, so far I was unmuted. Okay, now welcome back. Good morning, everybody. So I hope everybody understood yesterday's course. That is, we have seen what is differential equation and what are the types, how to form the differential equation, and how to, if at all differential equation is given, how to find the solution of the differential equation. And for any given differential equation, whether a solution exists, and if at all it exists, whether it is unique or multiple solutions. So these things we saw yesterday with some examples also. And at the end, I have asked some questions. So I don't know how many of you have gone to Google and posted those questions and got the answer. Have you done? Okay, so I just want to give you the answers first, and then we shall see.
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt you.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, your voice is a little bit not clear, ma'am.
Not clear, huh?
Not clear, ma'am.
No, ma'am, so far it was, actually I was in a mute mode. So that's why I
Yeah, that is okay, ma'am. Okay, now, ma'am. Like, still, just a little bit, some disturbance is there, ma'am.
Okay. I don't know, shall I stop the screen and then again...
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am. Now it's okay, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Okay. So, yesterday's answer we shall see first, and then we shall see some applications to differential equation. Now, the first question was, given a differential equation, will a solution exist? So, it may exist or may not exist, right? So, if we come to know that it is not existing, then we need not waste time to find the solution. Okay, so that is the answer for this. So this question is called the existence question. Whether a differential equation, see, we cannot say that all the differential equations we are getting from the practical application, that is what we call it as mathematical model. So when you do a mathematical model from a practical situation, then you can get many equations. One such equation is differential equation. So all the differential equations formed in reality may or may not have a solution. So if it exists, then it is called the existence. So we have to analyze first whether a differential equation, the solution will exist or not. And the second question was, if a differential equation does have a solution, how many solutions are there? So under this, we need to pose one more condition. See whether if a solution exists. Okay, done. The solution is existing. Now, whether it is unique, one solution or many solutions. So that is another question. So it is very simply, if you pose some condition, then for the solution to have a uniqueness, then the problem is solved. So certain conditions you put, then you can get a unique solution. So what are the conditions required? Suppose, see this example. We want to derive a differential equation that on a bar of iron, that is the temperature distribution on a bar of iron. When we heat an iron bar, so the temperature, how it is distributed, so that is one, that is the thing. So now here, for example, you take 10 identical iron bars to identical conditions. That is, they should all exhibit the same temperature distribution. Now, you know that see, depending upon the property of the iron bars, see, though we are taking identical iron bars, so we are not assured that all the temperature, all the bar will have the same temperature at any given time. So yeah, only one of our solutions will be accurate. Okay, so that we will know, we won't know which is the correct solution. Okay, so in such conditions, if you want to have a single unique solution, then certain conditions we can make. So this is naturally called as uniqueness. So for a differential equation, to have a unique solution, we need certain conditions or assumptions. That is a model thing. So we want a model. That is what, so sometimes we call it as initial or boundary value problem. That is, we first set the condition or set the assumption, and then we try to find the solution for the differential equation. So if a third one is, if a differential equation does have a solution, can we find it? So as I told you, all the differential equation may not have the solution. Okay, there are some unsolved differential equations also. One sample is y double x is equal to 1 by y of x. So this is not yet solved. That is, they conclude that it does not have a solution. So like this, many differential equations cannot be solved. So then that means, are we not going to have a solution for that problem, that real life problem? No, not like that. So we will be finding various other methods. So there are, you can even, but for this problem also, y double dash equal to 1 by sin x y of x. So you can have some numerical solutions. That is approximate solution we can have. Though we cannot find the exact solution, that is approximately, it may be y equal to this one. So in numerical methods, you will be studying how to solve a differential equation. That is more for mechanical and civil department people. You will be studying those things. Now, first application we are taking is growth model. Okay, so yesterday itself we have seen birth and death as a starting one. So that is actually from the birth till the death, we have differential equation into our life. So what is a growth model? So when there is a population growth, so we can form a differential equation by taking one proportionality constant. That is, the rate of growth with time is actually directly proportional to P, population. So the rate of DP, population changes over time. So that rate is directly proportional to the population. Why? Because the constant, actually here, this differential equation has got prey and predators. What do you mean by that? See, there are, in a population, when the predators increase, see, predators means even disease. So the cause of death, that is called predators. Prey. So prey is the life which is involved. So if predators increase, that is, the cause of death increases, then prey decreases as more get eaten up. But then the predators, so then what happens? The predators will have less to eat, isn't it? So and start to die out, which means more prey will survive. So all these factors develop into differential equation. These are the parameters. So interaction between the two populations are connected by differential equation. So this is a growth model. Now it is called exponential growth and exponential decay. So why? Because see, the natural growth equation is this, dy by dt equal to ky. So this is a general differential equation. So dy by the rate of change of y directly proportional to y itself. So here k is called the growth constant. So now what is the solution? As we seen yesterday, you have to integrate or separating the variables. You can say that y equal to y naught e power kt. What is that y naught? Y naught is the initial value of y. So this is the condition we are assuming, initial condition. Now, so we can see that depending upon the k, whether it is greater than 0 or less than 0, you call it as exponential growth or exponential decay. So if k is less than 0, your differential equation is dy by dx is equal to minus ry. And if r is mod k, that is absolute value of k, the solution will become y equal to y naught into e power minus r. So on the right hand side, this is a graph. So this graph, this is for exponential growth. So it is increasing, and dk is this one, the under one. So the second one, that is, in NK less than zero, your growth curve will be exponential decay curve will be like this. So it is decreasing. So this is growth and decay. And the next is mixing problem. It is some interesting thing. So here we are going to see in detail how to solve this mixing problem. First, we are going to develop the differential equation and then solve the differential equation. So now this is a tank. So liquid inside, and then the substance is getting mixed up, and then it flows outside. So this is a problem of substance dissolved in the liquid. So the liquid entering the tank may contain more of the substance dissolved or may not contain also. So now, but the liquid leaving the tank will have the substance dissolved in that liquid. So now, as usual, we have to assume a letter, that is our notation. So we are going to assume Q of T. So what is Q of T? It will give you the amount of substance dissolved in the liquid in the tank at any time. So inside the tank, now liquid is getting poured and the substance is getting dissolved. And after it is getting dissolved, it is going out. So at any time T inside the tank T, so what is the amount of the substance dissolved inside the liquid? That is given to be Q of T. Okay, now to develop a differential equation, when you develop a differential equation, what we expect? We expect an expression for Q of T. So that is what we want. See, directly in this practical problem, you cannot say Q of T equal to this much. This is the expression that we cannot say. So for that, first we will be able to only develop the differential equation, and then only you can find what is Q of T. So that is what we are going to do today. Now, before going into the solution development, we are going to assume that concentration of the substance in the liquid is uniform throughout the tank. See, that assumption you have to assume. Okay, so that is the concentration of the substance throughout the tank, it should be uniformly mixed. Now, what is the main equation? So, rate of change of Q of T. Q of T is the amount of the substance inside the liquid at any given time T. The amount of the substance dissolved in the liquid at any given time T. That is Q of T. Rate of change of Q of T. Now we want to find out dQ by dT. So rate of change of Q of T with respect to T, which is equal to, so how will you find rate at which, see, the flow has got some rate and the outlet inflow has got some rate and the outflow also has got some rate. So when you just subtract these two things, then you will get the rate of change of Q of T. So rate of change of Q of T is nothing but dQ by dT. That as I told you, this also can be denoted as Q dash of T. So rate at which Q of T enters the tank is out to find the rate at which Q of T enters the tank. So flow rate of liquid entry, rate of the liquid entering into concentration of substance in liquid entering. See, there will be some concentration of the substance in the entering liquid also. So that concentration of substance we should know. So then you can find the rate at which Q of T enters the tank. Similarly, rate at which Q of T exits the tank is flow rate of the liquid exiting into concentration of substance in liquid exiting. So when you just subtract these two things, you will be getting this Q dash of T. So this is the idea. So this is the main idea. That is, this is how we are going to form first equation. Okay, so this is of course the differential equation, dQ by dT. So dQ by dT equal to these two things. Now let us see with an example. Okay. So we want a numerical example for our brain to understand. So that is why we are going for numerical example. Now, so there is a tank. See, 1500 gallon. So its capacity is 1500. Okay. Initially, it contains 600 gallons of water. Right? So first, this is the assumption. So first, we are having the initial condition. Initially, it is having 600 gallons of water with 5 pounds of salt dissolved in it. Okay. So 5 pounds of salt, first it is dissolved. Now, water enters the tank. So the rate of entering the tank, is given to be 9 gallons per hour. Okay. So water enters the tank at a rate of 9 gallons per hour. And water entering the tank has salt. See, when it enters, it has got a salt concentration of 15 times 1 plus cos t. So this is the thing we want. We need to have this value. We should have. Then only we'll be able to form the differential equation. So 15 into 1 plus cos t. Now, so after entering it, the solution is mixed. So a well-mixed solution leaves the tank. At what rate it leaves the tank? So that is 6 gallons per hour. So that is also given. So rate at which it exits, that also is given. Now what is the question? How much salt is in the tank when it overflows? So at a given time t, we want to find out how much salt is inside the tank. So this is the question. I hope everybody understood the question first, isn't it? Okay. So a tank is there and liquid is entering with some concentration substance, and then after entering it is getting mixed with some salt, and then after that it is left. It is leaving the tank. So what are the things we are we know the volume of the tank and the whole capacity of the tank we know, and then initial volume we know, and then we have the rate at which the liquid enters and the rate at which the liquid leaves the tank, and also the salt concentration. So all these things we know. So now we shall put it in a table. What are all the things we know and what we want? So this is how a problem in mathematics has to be started. That is, you have to first list out what are the things you know, what are the values given in the question, and then what do you want actually. Okay, so now our first presumption is the instant the water enters the tank disperses evenly throughout the tank to a given uniform concentration of salt, because we know that water always finds its level, so it will not up and down, it will find its level and then it will spread. Liquid will occupy the space uniformly. So that is what our first presumption. Then first, so what we have got, flow rate of the water, that is 9 gallons per hour, and then concentration of the salt in the water entering, so this is given. Then flow rate of the water leaving, this is also given. So what is the concentration? Of course, that 1500, that is the capacity of the tank, I have not listed here, but whatever we want, I have listed. Okay. So now, initially we want to find out something. That is, uniform concentration is there in the salt. So the concentration at any point in the tank, and then the water is exiting, is given by concentration equal to amount of salt in the tank at any time t divided by volume of water in the tank at any time t. So this is a simple calculation. So the amount of salt at any time t is to be given as Q of t. And initial volume will be 600 gallons. Now, every hour, 9 gallons enter and 6 gallons leave. So in an hour, you have 9 gallons of liquid enters the tank and 6 gallons leave the. So at any time t, which means at a given time t, if you take t hours, so what is the amount of gallons of water in the tank? That is 600 plus 3t, because this is 9 minus 6. Okay, see, already there is 600. Every hour, 9 enter and 6 leave. So what is the difference? The difference is only 3. So that is 3 times t, 600 plus 3t gallons of water in the tank. So this is our given values. Now, see, more water enter the tank than leaves, because the amount of water entering the tank is higher, greater than the amount of water leaves the tank. So, which means the volume satisfies the differential equation. So, dV by dt will be gallons per hour in minus gallons per hour out. So, inlet minus outlet. So, that is 3. dV by dt equal to 9 minus 6. So, when you integrate dV by dt, or by separating the variables, dV by dt equal to 3, which means dV equal to 3 dt. So, integrating V equal to 3t plus constant. So, you have to find out the constant, value of the constant. So, initial value you take. That is, initially the tank contains 600 gallons of water, which means at time t equal to 0, the volume will be 600. Time t equal to 0, that is the initial value. So, put t equal to 0 here, V becomes C. Okay, so that is what is V. V is 600, which means C equal to 600. So, V equal to 3t plus 600. So, we have got a clear equation of the volume. Now, from this, we can see what is our question. Our question is, when the tank overflows, what will be the amount of, that is, what is the value of Q of T? So, that means we want to find T. Okay, so we should know T. Actually, we are going to solve for Q of T. Okay, Q of T is done. Yes. After many steps, we are going to arrive Q of T. So, after finding of Q of T, how you are going to give the answer? See, for that answer, you need the value of T. See, at what time the tank will overflow? That is a question. Okay. So, to find that T, you need an equation for T. So, that is what we have derived from here. T equal to V minus 600 by 3. Okay. So now keep thinking, after two slides, I'll be asking the question when the tank will overflow. That means, what is the value of T? So that you have to answer. Okay. So now, let us go into the problem, designing of problem. So this we have already seen. So again, to recall, rate of change of Q of T equal to rate at which Q of T enters the tank minus rate at which Q of T exits the tank. Of course, Q of T, rate, all these things we know. So now with this equation, we are going to form the differential equation. That is Q dash of T, rate at which the water inflow. That is 9 by 5, 1 plus cos T minus, because 9 into the rate, 1 by 5, 1 plus cos T minus 6 into the rate of Q of T by 600 plus 3T, given that Q of 0 equal to 5. Okay. So then at time T equal to 0, Q of T is equal to 5. Then Q dash of T is, so just simplify this, you can know, because from here you can take 3 outside, so cancel that 3 to 6. So it will be 2 Q of T, 200 plus T given Q of 0. This is a well developed differential equation. So this is the differential equation. This is how you find, you develop a differential equation from the given practical situation. So this, we know that this is a linear differential equation. Now we are going to solve this. So this minus, so bring this to left hand side, you will be getting Q dash of T plus 2 Q of T by 200 plus T, that is equal to something on the right hand side. So how to relate with what type of differential equation? That is linear differential equation, because the variables are raised to power 1. Okay. So under which type it comes? So you can see that Q dash of T plus P into Y. PT. Okay. So P into Y. So what is that P of T? 2 by 200 plus T. 2 by, so Q dash of T plus P into Q of T equal to capital Q. See, this Q you should not confuse with that. So Q dash of, it is like dy by dt plus py equal to Q. So this is the form. Okay, so here we'll be able to solve by using integrating factor. So what is that integrating factor? Mu of t equal to e to the power of e power integral pdx. I hope you remember. So 2 by 200 plus t into dt. So now you have to integrate this part. So 2 by 200 plus t, dt 2 you take outside, integral dt by 200 plus t, that is dx by x. You have to use log. So 2 into log of 200 plus e. So you know that log means, 2 times log means you can raise to the power. So that is e power 200 plus t the whole square. Log 200 plus t the whole square, and e and ln are reciprocal to each other. So that is why you are getting the answer as 200 plus t the whole square. So now, so integral 200 plus t the whole square q of t dash dt. So that is, so if you multiply this 200 plus t the whole square with this, okay, and then integrate with t, then multiply the same thing both sides. 9 by 5, 200 plus t the whole square, 1 plus cos t, because you want to find out the integration value. This is how you do it. So this integrating factor, mu of t, you are multiplying throughout and then integrating with respect to t. So when you multiply 200 plus t the whole square, left hand side as well as right hand side, so here you can get this, if you multiply here 200 plus t the whole square 2 dash of t, this term plus this term will give you, applying product rule, you can take that as the whole dash. The two terms put together will be 200 plus t the whole square 2 of t whole dash dt. So upon integration, this will give you only this amount, because integral this dash will get cancelled. So you will be left with 200 plus t the whole square 2 of t equal to something on the right hand side. Okay. So now t plus 200 the whole square. So the left hand side is 2 into, So you are getting like this, 2 into t plus 200 q plus, so I have shown whatever I have told you, I have shown here. So 2 into t plus 200 q plus t plus 200 the whole square dq by dt equal to the right hand side. So this left hand side put together, you can write it as d by dt of t plus 200 the whole square into q, because if you apply the product rule here, u, v. So u dash v plus d u dash. So u dash is 2 into t plus 200, that is what you find here, times u plus this into 2 plus t and u into v dash. V dash is dq by dt. So this is nothing but d by dt of t plus 200 the whole square into q, that is equal to the right hand side. Now upon integration, this d by dt and integral will get cancelled. You will be left only with this term, t plus 200 the whole square into q, that is equal to the right hand side. So how are you going to solve the right hand side? This is, of course, you have to use integration technique. So 1 plus cos t into t plus 200 the whole square. When you use that technique, integration by parts, you will finally get the answer as q of t equal to 9 by 5, 1 by 3, 200 plus t plus sin t. So these things you are, this is the final answer solution you are getting for q of t. Now, applying the initial conditions, that is at t equal to 0, q of t equal to 5. So when you apply, you can find out what is c, -460072. Okay. So now the amount of salt at any time t is given. So this is the final answer. Now can anybody tell me when the tank will overflow? There is a question. Yes, can anybody tell me when the tank will overflow? See, when a question is asked, you have to answer. I am not particular about the correct answer to be given. Some answer can be given. So that I want to know whether you are with me or not. Yes, anybody? Can anybody answer the question? I don't know whether I'm talking to only the laptop or to the people over there. It is a very simple question.
Ma'am, Vishnu Prasad wants you to repeat the question again.
Yes, the question is, when, at what time the tank will overflow? See, before two slides, I told you to remember this equation so that to find when the tank will overflow, at what time the tank will overflow. So the capacity of the Stands is 1500 and initially it is 600. Now at what time the tank will get overflowed? I have given you an equation for T. You have to do something with that. Okay. I think I have to answer the question. Right. So the tank will overflow at T equal to 300 hours. How? We got one equation for T. T equal to V minus 600 by 3. So you put the value of V, the capacity, the total capacity of the tank, you will be getting this answer. So T equal to 300 hours. The amount of salt at this time. So substitute T equal to 300 in this equation, you will be getting 279 LPS pounds. So this is the equation for U of T. At any time, this is how the rate goes. Is it clear? Okay. So now, next, we'll go to some chemistry. So in chemistry also, this differential equation plays an important role. That is, they want to find out rate loss. They have created the rate loss. That is, when a chemical reaction is being done, when a chemical reaction is there, so the reactant, some chemicals will react and then it will give you products. So at the rate at which the reaction is done, so that is very important. So it dictates whether reaction can occur during a lifetime. Also, many chemical reaction is being done. So knowing the rate law, an expression relating the rate to the concentration of the reactants can help a chemist to adjust the reaction condition. Okay. So now, an integrated rate law is an expression. There are two rate laws, differential rate law and integrated rate law. So what is an integrated rate law? It is an expression involving the rate of reaction and the species involved in the reaction. So this is a reaction. This A to B. So the rate of change of A. So this rate of change of A is dependent upon the concentration of A. So this is one reaction. So left, you know, the chemical reaction, you will have left hand side some reactions will be given and the right hand side will be the resultant of those things. So now in general you say that two reactants are the AA plus BB and which gives you the resultant product as CC plus BB. So rate is equal to K times A par M, that is M is the order. Mth order of different derivative, mth derivative of A and n into nth derivative of B. So it is m and n are orders of reactions. So they are actually these things are determined experimentally. And also each reactant has its own order of reaction. So the overall reaction is actually it will be added, both the orders will be added and then you can calculate overall reaction order. So differential law expresses the reaction rate in terms of changes in the concentration. So what is differential rate law? In this you will be having the changes in the concentration of one or more reactants, that rate, delta of R, over a given time interval. So integrated rate law describes the reaction rate in terms of the initial concentration. That is initially what is the concentration and one or more reactants after a given amount of time. So this is the difference between differential rate law and integrated rate law. Now, both will have a comparative study. So you can see that differential rate laws express the rate of reaction as a function of concentration change of one or more reactants. So that is differential rate law. Whereas integration rate law expresses the reaction rate as a function of initial concentration and one or more reactants after a specific time. Okay. So now they are used, differential rate laws are used to describe what is happening at the molecular level. But here they are used to determine the rate constant and the reaction order from experimental data. So this is the comparatively studying between differential rate loss and differential rate loss. Of course, the equation is like this: rate equal to minus dA by dt equal to k into nth order of A, and here ln A equal to minus kp but plus ln of A0 at first A at a given particular time. Now, there are many orders of reaction. So, the first order reaction is given like this. First order means the rate power 1, the derivative to power 1, that is rate equal to minus dA by dt, that is equal to kA. So, now separating the variables, you can find the solution A equal to A0 e power minus kT. That is what we are initially seeing, Y equal to Y0 e power minus kT. So, second order rate laws are given like this, minus K times A squared, and the nth law, of course, nth order rate law is minus K, nth order of A. So, this is how in chemistry also it is used. Now, next we shall see how electric circuits uses differential equations. Now, it is a resistor. So, it is a resistor is a, we know that any charges, light or bulb, that resists the flow of electric charge. So, resistors always obey Ohm's law. Ohm's law is V equal to IR. Then, V is the voltage applied to the resistor. I is the rate at which change charge flows through the resistor. And R is a constant of resistance. So now a capacitor, it is a circuit component that stores the supply of electric charge. So now we know this equation. So capacitors always obey this equation, V equal to Q by C. Okay, so what is Q? It is the charge stored in the capacitor, and C is the constant called the capacitance of the capacitor. So, V is the resulting voltage. So, V equal to rate of Q by C. That is the charge stored in the capacitor divided by the constant of the constant that is capacitance of the capacitor. Okay. So, combining everything, you get IR equal to Q by C. So, this you know, setting the two formulas, you get. So, the rate I at which charge flows through the resistor is the same as the rate at which charge flows out of the capacitor. So, which means I equal to dQ by D. So, we have this differential equation, I equal to dQ by D. Okay. So, now, putting these together, you get the differential equation minus dQ by dR equal to Q by C. Or, you can solve this Q equal to Q naught e power minus RT. So now, in the case when the resistor is a light bulb, this means the bulb will become dimmer and dimmer over time, although it will never quite go out. Okay, next comes Newton's law of cooling. Now, this model, actually, it is a change in temperature of an object in a given environment. So, we are trying to find the change in the temperature of an object. So, this law states that rate of change of the temperature is proportional to the difference between the temperature T of the object and the temperature T of the environment surrounding the object. So now we have to remember the death equation yesterday we have seen. So if you, that is the rate of cooling. How much you keep in mind what is the room temperature and what is the temperature of body, and between two periods you are taking the temperature of the dead body and then you try to find out. So that is Newton's law of cooling is applied there. So what is Newton's law of cooling? So this is the law. Rate of change of change in time of the temperature, that is dT by T, E capital T by dT. So temperature T is the object of the temperature. This is equal to minus K times T minus TE. So now you take this as X. So, actually, by using separation of variable, you can find again the same thing we are going to have, that is x is equal to a e power minus kt, which means t minus te equal to a e power minus kt. So, t minus te is equal to this. So, now put at t equal to 0, the temperature, you have some initial temperature of the body. So, that is we are in a dead body, we are assuming it as 98 Fahrenheit, isn't it? So, that if you substitute as condition T naught, then you will be getting the value of A equal to T naught minus T. So the final expression will be given like this, T of T equal to T plus T naught minus T into E power minus T. So we have started with the differential equation and we have arrived at the solution. So this is how, and I have picked up only those equations which are very, very light. Actually, there are many equations. We are going to see at the end what is the differential equation for COVID. That actually is a very tough equation to develop and to solve. But here, just for our understanding, I have taken some light equations. Okay, now you are taking an apple from the refrigerator. Okay, so with an initial temperature, now initial temperature of 170°C is removed from the, sorry, not refrigerator, from the oven. So even the other way also we can find. So after removing from a refrigerator, then it comes to the normal temperature. So that that depends upon the room temperature and the temperature of the apple. So now from the oven you are removing 170°C. Centigrade and leave it to cool. So with the room temperature of 20°C. Given that the temperature of the pie initially decreases at a rate of 3° per minute, how long will it take for the pie to cool to a temperature of 30°? Okay, so now of course it should obey Newton's law of cooling. So we are taking dT by T equal to minus K into T minus 20. So now given that initial temperature is 170 and the rate is minus, it is 3°. Okay. So now what is the solution? So as usual, you integrate by bringing this T minus 20 to here, to the left hand side. And then you will have log of T minus 20 and this is equal to minus KT plus C. So T equal to 20 plus C e power minus KT. And then when you solve, you are getting T as 20 plus 150 e power minus 0.023. So this is the solution you are getting after substituting the initial values. Because we have two constants, you have to solve, we are having two initial conditions. Then, it is one interesting problem, that is the bathtub problem. So now, there is one person who finds that his bathtub fills at a rate of 10 liters per minute, but leaks 6 liters of water per hour. So from being empty, the bathtub is full after 20 minutes and Ram can have his bath. So now, can Ram know how much water there is the moment he steps in? So when he steps in at time, some time T, so how much water will be there? Now here we are given rates of change, initial condition, and we have to deduce a state at some point. How many liters are there after 20 minutes? So after 20 minutes, how many liters are there? So the differential equation is dP by dT equal to F minus L. Okay. So that is the final thing. F, the actually, I'll give you. So the constant, the content B is the content of the bathtub. So how it changes over the time. Okay. Filled, this is the how much water it is filled, amount of water it gets leaked. So this this problem also you can solve and find that B of T equal to F minus T times T. So that there are B of 20 equal to, you suppose if you have a huge bathtub, okay, that is equal to one, that contains 198 liters of water in his bath, then if he took showers and got his bathtub fixed, so he would make substantial savings in his water bills. Okay, so this is a small problem. Then, actually, next one is analyzing the fall of a body. So free falling bodies which freely fall from the above. So now these both great mathematicians observed that rate of change in momentum encountered by a moving object is equal to the net force applied it. So F is equal to d by dt in times mv. Now F is the force, m is the object's mass, and v is the velocity. So now applying the product rule, you will be getting m times dv by dt plus v times dm by dt. So now actually m is a constant. So m will not vary, of course. The object's mass will not vary, but whereas v will vary, isn't it? So F is equal to M dV by dt. So or F is equal to M. So you first you consider it as a variable and then you apply the product rule. Suppose m is constant, then dm by dt will be 0. So you'll be left only with m into dv by dt. That is nothing but dv by dt is rate of velocity that with respect to time. Then that is nothing but acceleration. So f is equal to ma. Which is, what is this? This is Newton's second law of motion. So now the in a freely falling body, so the constant acceleration due to gravity, you denote it as g. Okay. Now propulsion. So the propulsion force due to gravity is Fp is equal to mg. But if you think a real body falling through the air, okay, that is a parachute is falling freely. So at some point of air resistance is a factor, isn't it? So air resistance will be a factor at about some point because the direction may change when a person falling from the parachute. Okay, so that you have to take into consideration. Now, so you get F is equal to Fp minus. So the resistance force also you have to take into consideration, and then the net force is Fp minus Fr. Fp minus for a freely falling body. So which means F is equal to, we found that m dv by dt, Fp is equal to mv, Fr is minus k times the velocity, where k is the constant of proportionality, and why minus? Because it is resisting, it is making the object to move upwards. So now solving this. So we have to solve this. First you remove, you divide throughout by m, so that left hand side will consist only the derivative dv by dt, g minus k by m. So when you integrate, you will get the solution. So u v equal to mg by k. That is the final equation. Velocity is mg by k. Okay. So now the body is actually initially moving faster. So dy by dt is negative. If the body is initially moving faster than this, then dy by dt is negative and the body slows down. Or if the body is moving at a velocity below and the body speeds up. So these observations we get here. See, d squared d, actually it is a second order equation. Second order differential equation, that is we determine, again you differentiate d squared d by dt squared, you will be getting d k minus k by m dv by dt. So this is the velocity dv, the rate of change of velocity is increasing. Here the rate of change of velocity is decreasing when the air resistance is there. Now again there are three situations. So actually this is nothing but this graph is compared with the Newton's law of cooling. So both the graphs are same. Here you are speaking in terms of velocity, here you are speaking in terms of heat. So this is Newton's law of cooling. This is what we are observing about a freely falling body. So these two things are comparable, and hence finally everything what Newton and Leibniz observed, that only is true, coming into effect. So this is what we are trying to say here. Okay. Now, in economics and finance also, one small example. So it is actually demand and compounding interest, you can see. When you have a demand and compounding interest, this can be calculated by this equation. Dp equal to K into D minus S into D. So even differential equation is applied in economics and finance also by giving the initial condition. So now, what we wanted, that is differential equation of COVID-19. This actually, I have taken one from research paper. So I just wanted to show you how differential equation for COVID-19 is built up. It is not actually, I'm not showing the construction. So I'm going to show you only the equation. So as far as to make it simple, I have taken some light things. So now, first you consider the case in which the population of individuals subjected to an infection is not too large. Actually, this data, this study was done in Italy. So in Italy, how the coronavirus spread in the early days, that is February, March. So those days, the study was conducted. Now, here we are going to consider a population. So that population means it is those populated, infected population, which have been infected by the disease. So now you take F naught. It is the number of initial infected persons. So when we started the study, so there will be some population, some number of population, amount of population will be there. So at time t equal to 0, you fix that time t as 0 and call this initial infected persons as F naught, number of initial infected persons as F naught. Now what is R? R is the rate of the infection, or how will you find out the rate of the infection? So the number of new infections from one infected person in one unit of time. So, or the number of new infections a day. So every day, even now we are getting, today the number of coronavirus cases is this. So that is the rate. So the that you have to find out the rate. Actually, even in finding out the rate also, we have to be very careful, because when you find the rate, actually the rate of infection, when you find, you just take the data correctly and then you find the rate of the infection. And P is number of individuals of the population involved. We are not going to take whole population, but the number of infected only, we are considering it as a population. Now, this is the diffusion equation they have arrived. That is, number of infected people at any time T, the rate of change with respect to t, that is df by dt, that is equal to r times f of t into 1 minus f of t by t. So p is the population, r is the constant, proportionality constant. So now if you solve this differential equation, you are getting the number of infected people at any time t is nothing but t, that is the infected population. You are taking one population, one group of people, into F naught. F naught is initially in at time t equal to 0, how many are infected, and e power rt divided by p plus F naught into e power rt minus 1. So now actually it is a moving equation, because it goes on increasing. But one disadvantage with this thing they say is it is a poor predictable power. So if we are unable to predict at the given time t, that is after 1 month, so what will be the how many people will get infected? So that is not given in this. Actually, this is not the only study in COVID-19, but there are many researches going on. Still, many papers are coming. Research papers are published. So there can be many effective differential equation also. So this is the one which I chose. So now, if you have enough data about the diffusion, why this is actually it is a poor predictable power? Because if you have enough data about the diffusion of the epidemic disease, especially in the first stage of spreading, now if you want to get a rough forecast, or what will happen in the near future after 1 month, so we can use the F naught, R and P as a free parameter. Okay. So that is why, so when you substitute F naught, R and P as parameters, somehow you can manage this situation. See, you can get only a rough figure. Rough forecast you can get. We cannot get the actual forecast. Now, actually, this differential equation, it does not contain the mechanism of reduction also. So how to reduce also, we don't know. So we have to take into account the number of closed cases, which means that also we have to consider. See, when you say that so many people are getting infected, now we are saying at the given time, 10 o'clock, you are saying the number of given infected people is F of T. But at 11 o'clock, maybe some would have been cured and some would have died. So those things you have to remove from F of T. F of T we have to take into consideration, that then we have to find out. So now actually this model, the model it includes the total number of infected person and the total number of recovered person. So that is why the model is being remodeled. That is R into, instead of R into F of T, you just write F of T minus R of T. That is number of infected person minus the person who have been recovered or died. So that you have to subtract. So F of T minus R of T and 1 minus F of T by T. And for further resolution of this equation, let us see what they are doing. Actually, there is an average time of recovery. So we have to find some recovering time T, so that the total number of cases at some given time, the very small time, delta T becomes closed cases. That is, you can take T as T plus delta T. Okay. So namely, R of T has to be taken to be F of T minus delta T. So this is R of T, you can find out, you can say that approximately it is F of T minus delta T. This delta T, these are all closed cases. That is, either they are in, at a given time, so T minus delta T will be very, very, delta T is a very minute time. So that you take into account. So here you can rewrite this equation as F of T minus delta T. Of course, it is only when we approximate. Okay. So when this happens, you can see that what is happening to this term, 1 minus F of T by T. Approximately, actually, it may lead to 1 also. That let us see. See here, this is the graph given in, actually, this study was taken in Italy, as I told you. So 21st February to 22nd March. So this is 21st February to 22nd March, nearly 1 month they have taken. So now R of T is actually it is the recovered or died. So that is given in blue. And this is the F of T. This is F of T. Okay. So now delta T, they have taken approximately 11 days. 11 days means from 21st February to 31st March, like that. So 1st March, so you can see that it is actually constant. Both are coincide. F of T and R of T are coincide. The number of infected persons and the number who got recovered or died. So this actually is flattened. So both are same at in 11 days. Okay, they fairly overlap with the total number of cases, right? So that is why we consider the case where the population P is very large. Now F of T, so the very large means F of T will be nearly less than P. So the number of infected persons is very, very less, comparatively very less. So that is why we, when it becomes very less, F of T is very less than P, lesser than P, then almost this will be equal to zero. That is one by this will be equal to zero. So that means because when the numerator is lesser than the denominator, actually it should be less than one. When you reduce reduce the numerator, still you reduce the, but P is constant, P will not vary, but F of T may vary. F of T will go down, decrease, and then finally it becomes zero. Okay, so it tends to zero. So that means approximately you can take 1 minus F of T into P is as 1. So that is why, so df of T by dt is rewritten as F of T R into F of T minus delta T into this Heaviside function. Heaviside function is a unit function wherein, see, actually this condition is there now. So two conditions are there. Either you take this as 1 or 0. So like this. So Heaviside function, you take it as 1 or the function, the value as it. So that is a Heaviside function, Heaviside theta function. So this equation is functional retarded differential equation. Okay. So till now, any doubts? Any doubts?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Ma'am, Shakti Vel is having a doubt. Why minus KT, ma'am? Why negative symbol in the front?
Where, ma'am? Here.
At 12-2 he has sent, ma'am.
Minus K, that is a freely falling body, no? That is the IR resistance is there. So that is why, see, when the velocity, actually when the resistance is pushing the body upward, always you have to put minus, negative sign. Okay? This is by Shakti Vel, ma'am. Ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. It was by Shakti Vel. I think now he is following, ma'am. So he has mentioned. And then there is another question by Muhammad Aksar.
Yes, ma'am. I don't know why I'm unable to see the chat box.
Ma'am, you want me to read out the question?
Yes, ma'am. I'll just try out.
Since differential equation doesn't give the reduction of pandemic, so it means we need to move on to some other equation like partial differential equation. Having so many parameters under consideration to solve problem.
Yes, that's correct. That is why I told you, see, not only this differential equation for pandemic is there, but there are many differential equations. See, I have not gone into partial differential equations at all. So, if you go to partial differential equation, you can find accurate solutions also. But still, we are struggling for a solution for this pandemic. That is what it shows. If at all there is a solution, we would have been relaxed from lockdown, isn't it? So we are unable to find the solution. Even mathematically also, we are struggling. Okay.
Yes. Ma'am, next, Shakti Vel has a doubt in slide number 39. He wants you to repeat that once again.
31, ma'am.
39, ma'am.
39. Yes. Okay. So that is, see, you consider the case in which a population of individuals infected. That is, you are taking F naught. That is, first, you are taking initially at time t equal to 0, how many persons are infected. Okay, R is the rate of the infection. The number of new infections from one infected person in unit of time. So R is some rate of the infection, how it is getting spread. So from one person to 4, one person to 5. So that is how you find the rate. Then P is the number of individuals of the population involved. That is, if you are going to take in a particular area, that is, for example, the study is taken in Italy. So what is the population involved? How Italy population of the Italy they have taken. So this is the explanation for this slide. You want me to tell me anything? Anything else? I hope I'm clarified. I have clarified you. Okay. So any other doubts? Okay, so next, actually, I am almost done because applications, you can go on telling. So I want you to try out these problems. That is, first one, a cell culture is growing exponentially with a doubling time of 3 hours. If there are 5,000 cells initially, how long will it take for the cell culture to grow to 30,000 cells? Okay, then another next question is, capacitor with a capacitance of 5 coulombs per volt holds an initial charge of 350 coulombs. The capacitor is attached to a resistor with a resistance of 8 volt second per coulomb. So the question is, how quickly will the charge held by the capacitor initially decrease? And one more question is, how quickly will the charge be decreasing after 20 seconds? Next, a bottle of water with an initial temperature of 25 degrees centigrade is placed in a refrigerator. with an internal temperature of 5, given that the temperature of the water is 20 C, 10 minutes after it is placed in the refrigerator, what will the temperature of the water be after 1 hour? So this is a daily activity question. Okay, so you can try out this. If you have any doubts, you can mail to me, or even if you find an answer also, you can mail it to me. So that's all. Any more doubts?
Participants, do you have any doubts further? Any doubts, participants?
If you have any doubts, you can put it in the chat box.
Participants, I have shared the feedback form link to you. So you please fill up the feedback form. That form will be open till 2 o'clock today, and afterwards it will not accept responses, sir. So please don't come back saying that I have not filled the feedback form today and asking for your certificate. So please fill it up within 2 o'clock today in order to get your certificates mailed to you. Thank you, Tamil Selvi ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Participants, you have any further questions or clarifications, you can please raise your hand or post it in the chat box. Any further doubts, participants? Okay. Principal ma'am?
Ma'am? Principal ma'am? Principal ma'am?
Principal ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. I'm online.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, you have any points to add?
You have included that point yesterday itself. You have mentioned, ma'am, anybody is joining in engineering.
Yes, ma'am. Today's feedback also, I included the same point, ma'am.
And if you are studying in some college, you can refer your friends to Alpha. Whatever their experience here, you can ask our students as well. It would be a good opportunity for the students to learn. So we welcome many students to join Alpha College of Engineering. You can even refer our college even if you're not doing plus two on your own. So that message you wanted to convey, Sujata ma'am. Anything else, ma'am?
Yes, nothing, ma'am. I think it is all clear for the participants. I'm seeing no questions in the chat box. Questions.
Yes, ma'am. So we will...
Ma'am, Mohammed, he is having some...
machine learning.
Yes, Mohammed, we have been seeing your this thing. We will, as we are not doing machine learning session as of now, we may be planning to do it later. So actually, I have told ma'am to note down your number so that when such thing happens, we will be getting in touch with you. Webinar on machine learning or anything. And if you want to do on your own and start right now, somebody will guide you. We will do it right. Greatly, I feel, because this session is all about mathematics and not for machine learning. Any other course if you are interested in doing online, that like this webinar, then you can even fill in the feedback form where they would have mentioned that such, ma'am, that has been mentioned in feedback form, ma'am.
Sujata, ma'am. Yes ma'am. So
apart from, it need not be only mathematics, any subject which you are very keen to learn, you can mention that in your feedback form. We will come up with a webinar on that. Since all these things are happening through distance learning now, we will be coming to your home through net and we will be teaching you those things. So whichever course you are interested in, just you do share whatever course you want through feedback.
Ma'am, I'm sorry for the interruption.
Anything further?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, dear students,
your voice is breaking.
Yes. Now it's okay, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Dear students, actually, we are happy to see many college students are participating in this webinar. Actually, our aim was for the plus two students because they only struggle more when they come into engineering college or even arts and science college. So that is why we have started this course. But still, but we welcome actually the some of the well-known college students are coming and attending this course. So I request you to tell your friends, those who are in school, that is those who have just now completed plus two, so they can attend these webinars. See, whatever be the course, whether it is maths or chemistry or physics or anything, so you can also refer those friends, and we will be happy to conduct this webinar in any subject for the school students. So that is actually our focus is on them, because so we find all the engineering aspirants, see, they have they want to study engineering, but still they lack in the basics. So if we fill up that that gap, then it will be very easy for them to proceed engineering subject. Actually, engineering is a very important, very powerful, actually in these days everybody should study engineering, because and also it should be studied in a correct manner. That is, see, you should not follow the rote learning. So you should understand and then proceed, because engineering is not just like that. You get a degree. So if you are an engineer, you have the responsibility in the society. Actually, you have to understand the subject. So for that, this bridge course will be very, very helpful. So I request all the students to pass on this message to those who are studying plus two of among your relatives and friends. And then you just ask them to associate with our college. So even we welcome those students to study in Alpha, because as you know, Alpha actually it is a place only for the focusing is only mainly on the students. So we are, because more than 50 years this institution is in Chennai doing service to the students community. So and we will be doing this continuously, only focusing only the students' welfare. So even our principal and management, actually they are very much well versed in their subject. And principal ma'am, you can see that her knowledge is really widening, and she has got many ideas to improve our teaching methodology in Alpha. Actually, it is at par with all the colleges, all the top colleges, but still, we want to improve them again and again. So please, I request all the students to pass this message to your friends and relatives who are in school. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Participants, once again, I have shared the link with you. You can fill it up within 2 o'clock. Ma'am, you please continue. Yes, ma'am. Principal ma'am? Principal ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You please go on. Yes, ma'am.
Actually, ma'am, what we are offering is for student community. So we do offer it for school students because we find them lacking, as ma'am has very well said. So they do lack in basic understanding of mathematics. That's why we thought of offering mathematics as a course. So we find that engineering mathematics aptitude is a must. So whatever we find in a students or whoever comes to engineering, it need not be all over the all over Tamil Nadu or even India. I can say that we find that though they aspire to be engineers, the number of students joining engineering and the student with the right aptitude in mathematics is lacking. So that's why we have chosen mathematics as a bridge course, so that they will be learning some basic mathematics, and with that they can build on their engineering skills. So that's why we have started this bridge course on mathematics. So if the webinar is going to be something else and it is meant for all other students, then we will be again posting it on our website and we will be sending the invite. So you can very well join now. Anything else, ma'am?
Yes, that's all, ma'am. No, ma'am.
So we'll be hosting another webinar next week. We are hoping to see you there. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Participants, the webinar details for the forthcoming sessions will be posted to you since we have all your mail IDs now. So we will surely send you a mail intimating any further webinars from our side. Next week, you still have the webinar, I believe. So we'll be posting about that. Thank you all. Thank you for the participation.
Thank you, participants.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
You have been doing this non-stoppingly. That is from the continuous sessions you have been offering. And how much hard work went on. It is not so easy to prepare all these things, I know. So though it is easy handling a class on a whiteboard and making it ready in a PPT with all these mathematics equations and other things, it would have cost you time. And your effort really is paying, I feel, because all these students are learning from you and they are giving good feedback as well. So thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, participants, for being here.
Thank you, ma'am.